In this video, we will provide information about why ballast is needed, how to minimize it, and some practical examples on how to connect it properly to your structure. Due to wind, structures are prone to overturn, uplift or slide. Ballast or anchorage should be provided to ensure adequate resistance against these effects. The amount of ballast needed depends on many things. First, the size of the external forces acting on the structure. The higher the wind speed, the higher the wind pressure, and thus the more ballast is needed. Second, the height to depth ratio. A structure with a given height and a small footprint needs more ballast than the same structure with a large footprint. Third, the way a structure is cladded with fabric. If a roof has just a top canopy, it needs less ballast than the same one which is cladded on three sides. Fourth, the self-weight. The higher the self-weight, the less ballast is required. Fifth, if a wall canopies are connected to towers, in this case, the wind moves the tower base, ballast keeps this from occurring. Six, the safety factor used for unfavorable loads. This can vary between 1.1 and 1.5, depending on the type of load or applicable standard. Seven, the friction between the structure and the surface it's standing on. If the surface has a low friction factor, the wind can easily move it. And eighth, the last, structural design. There are different options for stabilization. For example, different guy wire arrangements have different effects on the amount of ballast needed. In order to minimize the amount of ballast, several measures are possible. First, using scrim or netting. In order to allow for a significant reduction of ballast, the net requires an open structure that does not give the user protection against the weather. Besides, the scrim needs to be certified for wind permeability. Second, interconnected tower bases. This can be achieved by a proper stage structure that's able to bear the lateral forces, a compression beam placed between tower bases, or ground anchors. For a common roof of 12 by 10 by 7 meters, these measures can lead to a 30 to 40% reduction of the ballast. Third, increase friction between the supporting screw jacks and the surface it's built upon. For example, a steel screw jack placed on a plain wood has a friction factor of 0.4. When embedded, 0.6, but if placed on rubber, 0.9. Stacked wood pads should be screwed together to achieve the highest friction factor possible. To make a sound structure, the method of connecting ballast is vital in activating its full weight. Let's go through some examples. First, if external ballast blocks are used, they should be connected in the center of the ballast mass in order to make use of its complete weight. Second, if ballast is used next to towers, it must be placed against the tower base and strapped to it to avoid lateral displacement. To prevent uplift on the roof, the ballast must be guided to the sleeve block, or the sleeve block needs to be pinned to the tower. We are confident this video has given you enough information to safely build your structure.